All right, welcome to the Autauga Football Review, brought to you by the 2018-19 Autauga Media Class. I have Coach Bobby Carr here. How you doing, Coach?
How you doing, Coach Bobby?
Good to see you. First installment of the Autauga Football Review. First we're going to talk about is how was the summer this year for the team?
I think the summer went really well. Got a lot of new faces, and I think that's the challenge for our coaching staff is to get everyone on the same page. We got guys from 9 different towns. Coming up in different backgrounds and so forth, and we're all born in a selfish world, and I think the biggest challenge is to get our guys to put their own selfish wants and needs aside, do what's best for the team, and once they can learn to do that, that's when we start to experience greatness, and it's been good. I think our kids have bought into everything we've tried to instill in them, and hopefully they'll continue to grow together as a team and learn to hold each other accountable and learn to understand each other a little more and respect one another.
Absolutely. Going into the summer, going to the 7-on-7s, how did that, I know we went to a lot of them. I know we say we're kind of 7-on-7 out after that last one, but give us a little bit of what happened there.
Well, I think we like to do that every year because a lot of it's because of what we do offensively, but it also helps our defense out. But I think it challenges our guys because we try to play against tougher competition, bigger schools, and I think that hopefully our kids will benefit from playing better competition in the summer, and then we'll get better at that, come season.
Gotcha. What about summer workouts? How'd those work out this year?
They went well. I think you guys did a great job of pushing our guys and they responded the way I think they needed to respond, and only time will tell. But it looks like things have gone really, really well up to this point.
Going into fall camp, we had a couple of weeks of fall camp before our first games. How did fall camp go? Did it go kind of like you thought? Did we start off slow? What did you think about the fall camp?
I thought it went well. I think this year's team has a lot of depth, so we've had to practice a little different than what we've done in the past. Fortunately, with the depth, we're having guys only playing one way. We've got a few crossover guys, but most of our guys are just playing one way. And again, hopefully that pays off in big ball games. And because a lot of our competitions haven't played guys that play both ways. So even if the guys do have to cross over and play, I think with the work ethic that you guys have instilled in the weight room and the conditioning program Coach Tate's done, I think it'll pay off.
Good deal. Now, going into the first two games, I know we're kind of a little late on this installment, but we played Bessemer, North Florida Christian. Bessemer was at Birmingham Southern. So talk about the Bessemer game, your thoughts, just how it went, first game with this new group of guys, and what'd you think about that?
Yeah, I mean, talking to Coach Rod at the beginning of the year, we wanted to play open season at a neutral site and play on a collegiate campus. I think the kids, both teams, were fired up and excited about playing at Birmingham Southern. But it went well. I think the biggest thing is we were very, very inconsistent in a lot of ways. We looked really, really good on some drives on offense, and then other drives, obviously, like I said, very inconsistent. A few too many penalties and so forth, but the mistakes we've made are easy fixes. So we'll continue to get better, continue to improve on those things.
Gotcha. Now going to North Florida Christian. I know we had to go down to Tallahassee, long trip, and I know we had a little bit of a delay, to say the least. Talk about that game and just the way that it's promoting our program and just getting out of the state of Alabama and playing a big profile team like North Florida.
Yeah, it's something we've been wanting to do and we've been talking about. And luckily for us, Coach Price had an open date and we were able to make that happen. Obviously, the game didn't turn out the way we wanted it to, but I think we got better as a team from that. And I thought it brought some notoriety to our program. In a lot of ways, some coaches probably are hesitant about stepping outside of their comfort zone. And I think that's the only way to get better is to step out and play teams like that, because I know it'll make us better down the road. That ball game was obviously, it was different. I mean, playing down there 4 hours away and then having a 2-hour lightning delay, rain delay, and then having to shorten the game up. But like I told our players, we're not going to make any excuses. We had plenty of opportunities to score. We didn't capitalize on some drives. We scored a couple times, got called back for penalties. So, again, I think you learn a lot more from a loss than you do a win. And we're definitely a better ball club because we went down and played those guys.
Absolutely. Now, this week we play Coosa Valley Academy. I know a little bit about that. Was there for a year and a half. What do you think about the game?
You know, we're focusing on us right now. You know, I don't know a whole lot about Coosa Valley. I haven't played them in years. You know, but our biggest concern, we had a bye week last week, so we've really been working on us. And the challenge to our guys is we just got to work on us to continue to get better, to be the last team standing at the end of the year. But we're excited about going up there and playing them.
I know we've had a little bit of a long weekend, a Labor Day weekend, and we didn't really get out there on Monday. How was practice yesterday? You know, how do you think practice is going so far? I know we got one today. So how do you think that went yesterday, kind of preparing for Coosa Valley?
I thought yesterday's practice was as good a practice as we've had all season. I think our kids are finally getting the things that we're trying to instill. I think the tempo is where it needed to be on offense. The enthusiasm was up, and that's the thing. You know, coaches have to coach, but we want our players to encourage one another and continue to lift each other up and continue to grow together.
What are some keys to the game to pull out this victory this weekend? We have a little keys, you know, defense, offense, special teams.
Yeah, we just want to be sound in all three phases, offense, defense, special teams. I think we want to execute. We want to be consistent. That's the one word we've been trying to emphasize with our guys is just be consistent. If we're just consistent in what we do, I think we're going to be fine right now.
Now, leads to my next question. You know, we have some key players. What are some key either groups or – you know, offensive line, D-line, skill, quarterback, receiver, running back, DBs. What are the key players that we need to watch for this game?
Well, I think our defense as a whole has played really, really well all year for us. You know, in fact, they're a little ahead of the offense right now, I feel like. And, so our emphasis has been on being more consistent on the offensive side of the ball. So I'd look for those guys to have a breakout ball game, the entire group.
I got you. And where and what time we play?
Harpersville, 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. Be live streamed this week. We'll have it on something called Meritix. Please check with the AAG Facebook page, and we'll have the link to that. Also check Twitter, which is Autauga Academy Football, or Autauga Football, for any updates. Brother Joey Fine will be doing that. Coach Carr, I want to appreciate you having this for our first installment, and go Generals. Yep. All right, we are back for the Autauga Football Review. This is our play-in review with Coach Bobby Carr. We're going to talk about one of our RPO plays this week. Coach, go ahead and tell us what formation and what defense that we have that we're going to be looking at.
We're going to see a 3-3 stack this week, and you know, what we're doing, this is our what we call our train formation with our slot and split, and we just take our plug back over here to the slot split side. And this is really like an ISO play, and we're tagging an RPO off of it, and, you know, there's a lot of different tags you can do off of it. This is just one that I particularly got from Wake Forest a few years ago. We actually call it Deacon because their nickname's the Demon Deacons. And so we're running our ISO play here. And you see how we got it drawn up. We're going to double to the backside. We're going to double the nose to the mic. We're going to ISO our plug back up inside. And actually, our quarterback's going to be key in here because we feel like we're going to beat him. We're running a quick slant here. Our backside receiver is going to run a slant and go over the top of the safety in case his safety is starting to cheat down here. We got the quick home run ball, but more times than not, our quarterback, since his first key is here, if he steps in, which he should, we're going to throw it right behind him right there in that window. And obviously, for some reason, if he's not there, we're handing it off. But that's been a really good play for us. A couple other things we can do off of it. We can even run a bubble route here and run a slant with our guy. And now we're keying here, running the same play. So, like I said, there's a lot of different options we can do there. And we've got a lot of skilled guys that can make plays for us in space. So our objective is we want to be a good power run scheme with all of our formations. But We've got guys that can make plays in space, and that's why we try to tag an RPO to most of our running plays.
RPO. Tell them what RPO stands for, in case they don't know.
RPO is just run pass option. That's what you see a lot of collegiate teams do it. In fact, you see now some of the NFL teams. In fact, the Philadelphia Eagles do it an awful lot. And, you know, they're wearing a Super Bowl ring right now. So
absolutely. Well, thank y'all again for this is the Talking Football Review Play in Review with Coach Bobby Carr.